Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Trofunet, and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. The enemy is at our doorstep. The Avenger has been disabled with an EMP blast. The aliens want their ship back, but we're not gonna let them. So I'm actually gonna swap out. The proximity mine could be handy. You know what? Let's just keep it the way it is. So this is a squad we're gonna head in with as a start. So Emma, Jazz, Ulrich, Yang, Vinny and Cedric, here we go. There we go. Ulrich is apparently slow walking towards our objective. Because he's the leader of the squad at the moment.
Menace 1-5, situation critical. Primary Avenger systems are offline and hostiles are moving to engage. Shen, any updates?
Commander, we've got a critical system failure. The Avenger is dead in the water. I'm diverting reserve power to the scanners, and they're picking up a powerful radiation source nearby. We need to locate and destroy whatever it is disrupting our systems.
It's actually not that far away.
We're picking up heavy comm traffic. Dozens of Advent transports are inbound on our position, and they've got battleships in tow. The aliens are sending everything they've got. We have to get this ship off the ground, or we may not make it out of this one.
So there we go. We have two turrets now, because I didn't have that the first time I did this mission. And those are the turrets from the defense matrix that are upgraded, if I'm not mistaken. So we should still have those guys. And the other thing this mission has, it seems like it's a defense mission, but it really isn't. We need to head towards the other side of the map as fast as we can. Because, yeah, otherwise we're going to have a bit of a problem. Just move everybody as fast as we can. We're not in concealment, obviously. So heading as close as we can, as fast as we can, is our best option. Even if that means not putting soldiers in concealment. Cedric, he can't really grapple to anywhere. So I'm just gonna put him right behind this cactus. Seems as a start. Put the XCOM heavy turrets on Overwatch, if I get them. Thank you. And everybody else as well. I am actually gonna conceal with Jazz and use him as a scout as fast as we can. And yeah, it doesn't seem like we can see a lot of those guys yet. I'm gonna put most of the guys here on Overwatch.
Affirmative, covering now.
Yeah, I'm just gonna do that and then put Ulrich right over here so we have a heavier guy available when the troops start falling down. There we go. There's two. An officer and a shield bearer, but they're gonna get hell here. That was a miss. I don't know what hit it there.
That is not good.
Ooh, 13 damage, a critical on Overwatch, so that's the perk. Is that turret gonna do something or what? Oh, hello. That's a codex. I do need to hack those, but
provides the ideal opportunity to infiltrate the
Advent. Oh, Jeebus Christ.
We will need to move in with the Skulljack to initiate the process.
Oh, ho, ho. Do you guys think what I'm thinking? The game is freezing, but okay. That's
Commander,
seven enemies.
Reinforcements in from the Avengers reserves.
And there we go. So we're getting extra troops. Can I see who? So there's Benito, another colonel. So this is going to be awesome. Because the first time I did this, it was with a lot. It was a lot earlier in the playthrough, and I had a bit of an issue there because, well, most of my other guys were rookies. Oh Jesus Christ! And I love the music during this mission as well, by the way. Look at that. That is, I think it's six enemies because the codex isn't visible at the moment. But blast away.
No use running.
Lemo. Taking a bit of a turn, and then detonating. Goodbye! Oh, they didn't see us yet. That was interesting. Spotted flanked enemy, that's not bad. And is he gonna... What the hell is going on? Is that my turn now, or what? What is going on? I can't see anything. They're still, yeah, they're still doing shit. Ooh, what is that? There's a lot of, holy shit, there's a lot of enemies in here. Okay. We don't have Jazz's ability yet that he can sword strike from one enemy to the next, so that is not something we can do. But, of course, look at this. This is a prime opportunity for face-off. Let's see, I have a few other enemies. Are there weaker enemies in my crosshairs? It doesn't seem like it, so perfect opportunity for face-off. Might actually put him in cover first. Although if I do that, do I see the codex now? I'm just gonna keep him here, I think. Because face-off, yeah, I'm just gonna kill everything. One kill. Two kills. Even with the dodge. Three kills. Oh, that was a miss. That was sad. Oh, come on. Jesus Christ, that was freaking awesome. That was three enemies down and a promotion. Well earned. That was... And the fucking music isn't helping because I'm really pumped now. I can't skill jack anything from here, so that's not that big of an issue. I'm just going to spread them out a bit. Can I fire at something with the turret? I can with this one. So a chrysalid and another chrysalid. So 8 to 10 damage. Fire away. That takes out the cactus, not the chrysalid. Can I fire again, as with most turrets? I can, so let's fire at the heavier chrysalid again. And take it out. Very well. Okay, next up. I think Ulrich should be the next one to fire. Although I might actually... So that's the codex hiding behind the tree over there. The other bit of the codex, probably, because there's one over there as well. Chrysalid from Emma. There we go. Dodged, but that killed it nonetheless.
Target neutralized.
Indeed. Then we have... We still have a lot of shots available to us. Good go for the codex in the back there, because he's gonna come bite me in the ass otherwise. But I'm gonna use the lightning reflexes. Lightning hands first on the Muton. It's a low percentage shot, but if I hit it, he's down. There we go. Critical. 5 damage. Goodbye, Muton.
You know that was good.
And now we actually have. Do I put him on kill zone? That would be awesome as well. So the heavy turret on Overwatch anyway. And then we have 2 more codexes left. I barely can see the stuff over there, but there's 6 more enemies around that. Jesus Christ. So yeah. Take out the codex. Blammo! 10 damage. Goodbye, codex. And then we have 1 more codex available, I think. And 3 more soldiers available. So that is really good. I'm gonna move... Ooh, where do I move Ulrich so he can fire at the codex without triggering anything else? So Ulrich now has a shot at the codex. Try it out. Yeah. Okay. So that's good. So now we can put everybody closer again. We know where they are, so if we are able to get closer, maybe even with Christophe. Although Christophe doesn't have reconceal, so I might just put Benito as close as we can. I do need to be careful not to put too many guys closer, because we do need to retreat after we're done. But let's just put everybody on Overwatch for now. And of course that explodes. Reducing it to half cover instead of full. Oh, that's really good. That is really good. So they're coming to us instead of the other way around. So he's going on Overwatch, but we got a shotgun blast on the trooper. Ooh, on the Lancer. Doesn't that kill him? 11 damage and he's not dead. So one health left. Okay. Interesting. So it's just a heavy mech. So if I just blast away... Oh, what? Vinny can't see the heavy mech. That is interesting. Let's put him over there. I could hack the mech because I don't need to retreat the mech, of course. If I'm able to hack the mech... Ooh. Just gonna have to be careful here. So I'm gonna use Vinny first. to try and reduce the hack defense of the mech. Maybe even with a lightning reflex. Ooh, we can't see the mech from here. Okay. So then I'm gonna have to try a hack without it then. How much does, ooh, capacitor discharge. And combat protocol does 10 damage as well. But let's go with haywire protocol. Let's see what we can do on that mech. If we can get it, that would be awesome, because then there's a unit in between us and the thing we need to destroy. 100% for a stun and a 50% to temporarily take control. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take that. Shit. Okay. Aim and defense stats of this unit has been improved. Okay. That is annoying. Especially since that just blocks off any access to MI I had. Benito. You can't even hack it. That is interesting, but I can. Oh, I can't even combat protocol the mech either. And he's still on Overwatch, so as long as I don't... Is this a saturation fire shot? I think it should be. Can we hit the device from here? Doesn't seem like we can. It would be nice though. But saturation fire... Yeah, I think we're gonna do that. It apparently didn't... Yeah, it didn't damage the device in the back. Which is sad, but nonetheless. Absolutely. Let's move Yang up a bit as well. Lightning reflexes on the... And now I can see the mech. Because I destroyed the tree, yeah. So lightning reflexes on the mech. That's a miss, but we still have another pistol shot. And so I am going to try that. Can I actually wait a second? I could try and hack it now. Again. Yeah, let's try that. I just wanna have that mech. Because we have two hackers now, but I think his chances are gonna be less because he doesn't have the skull jack. What are your shots? 86 and 44. Well, I'm just gonna do it again. Ooh, yes! Yes! Fuck you! This is my enemy now, and I think his aim and defenses are boosted. So that's a nice combo, I suppose. So that's our mech. That is gonna trigger the guys in the back next to the disruptor. So we're gonna have to be really careful, because that, of course, expands our range. And it's gonna trigger those three guys. No biggie, we still have a lot of guys left. And I think we even have the shredder cannon left, if I'm not mistaken. Although I'm not really sure if we would be able to use that. I can't toss a grenade over there, probably. No, that's way too far. So let's just put Yang on Overwatch, because she can't really do anything else. Cedric, he actually has a nice shot. So if I do kill zone. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Yes, sir. I'm gonna reload. And then I'm gonna put kill zone in that direction. So just the entire area over here. Kill zone it. And then we have an Overwatch with Vinny. Overwatch with the turret. Jazz, who could come closer and use a mimic beacon. So let's just use the mimic beacon over here. There we go.
And cover.
Yeah, try and attack that. The mech is hacked and those three other guys are just gonna... They're gonna try and move and they're gonna get shot by Cedric. So there we go. Because Cedric has an amazing sightline here. Blum! That was a miss. That seemed like it hit, but apparently it didn't. We still have an Overwatch shot with Vinny, maybe? That was another miss. And now he's gonna probably attack the Mimic Beacon, yeah. 7 damage. What are those vipers going to do? So they're gonna try and do something as well, so... That's a very long shot. Oh, come on, that was a hit. Oh, Yang shot. Kill him, kill him. Goodbye. Thank you very much. And then we have the other viper. Ooh, promotion for Yang. Yes, 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 yes. And another Overwatch shot from Cedric. Yeah, our defenses are pretty much impenetrable. Goodbye. Goodbye. Oh, damn, I love this. I love this game. And then this guy is just gonna stab the Mimic Beacon. And it's gone. But yeah, we can deal with what we have now. I'm wondering how big of an autoloader did we get with Cedric? Because if we can't reload...
I'm sending reinforcements in from the Avengers reserves.
I'm wondering why you don't do that immediately. So there's gonna be a spawn on the left.
Situation just got worse. Resistance outposts are reporting enemy transports on the move across this region. They're getting ready for an all-out assault.
I apparently can't fire at the disruptor from over here, probably because of the rock here. Which is interesting. So I think the smartest thing to do now is I'm gonna reload with him. I'm gonna reload with Cedric.
Ready to go.
And that was his first action, so I can actually fire at the Lancer. I'm just gonna do that. There we go. He grazed. We grazed. But that still was a kill.
No, that was good. Find something.
Okay, so just because I can, I'm just gonna take the loot. And there's the objective.
We have visual confirmation on the disruptor.
Oh, maybe we didn't have visual confirmation. Okay, so let's destroy this thing as fast as we can. It doesn't have that much health. But we do need to take care of everything else as well, so... Can I now fire at the machine? No, we can't. So I am going to use the mech. Could fire at the Arkham, but I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to use the micro-missiles to fire at myself and those rocks over here. Yeah, like this. So we can destroy that cover. It should open up a sideline to everybody else. Yes, friendly fire indeed. And that destroys that rock, and that hopefully opens up a sideline for everybody else. Vinny, yes, 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 there we go. So now we can sniper rifle the shit out of that thing. I'm gonna put Emma a bit closer because we still need to take care of that Archon. So there we go. 6 damage for combat protocol. I'm gonna keep that as a last resort. Turrets on Overwatch as always. Shotgun, the Archon. 5 damage because he grazed. We grazed him. Okay. How close can we get Yang? Benito could get in as well. Could we get combat protocol in? Oh yeah, I think... So let's try that as a start, because we do want to kill that Archon. There's a one hit. And then we have Yang, who can't apparently reach him. But maybe with an acid bomb we can? No. Just out of reach. That's annoying, so... Yeah, Overwatch it is then. And then the sniper shot. 84 at the Archon. I'm gonna have to take that. Oh, there we go. Okay. That's good. I wonder if I can use combat protocol on the... Can I use combat protocol on the thing? No. I could use it on the mech if I start to lose it. But I'm gonna put Emma closer as well. Maybe just put her on Overwatch. And then the turret on Overwatch as well. Oh, and Geralt is here as well. Let's put him on the left side. Because I think there's going to be enemies on the left.
Moving to position.
Any second now. And Ulrich. I knew Ulrich could still do something. Let's put him over here. I'm gonna have to reload him, sadly. Although, you know what? One action isn't that bad, and just put Geralt on Overwatch as well. Extra troops incoming. An officer and a mech. That's not that bad. We can take care of that rather quickly. Where are they exactly? Because I think they're pretty far away. And they're gonna keep spawning them over there, of course. Jesus Christ, okay.
Menace 1-5, be advised, we've picked up hostile reinforcements inbound on your position.
Cedric, fire at the disruptor. That's guaranteed damage every single time. So if we, there we go, 9 damage. Because you can't miss that thing, so everybody who's in range can actually fire at it. Jazz. Do you just fire at the thing and get it over with? I think we should. So yeah, let's just fire at the thing, destroying it, and let's get the hell out of here. Does that count as a kill, by the way?
Target destroyed. Excellent work, Menace 1-5. Shen, what's our status?
Whatever it was, destroying it seems to have lifted the disruption field. Engine control systems are coming back online. We should be clear to take off within 60 seconds.
Commander, we can take off on your order. We should get the squad on board and get moving.
So I'm gonna use the mech I hacked as a mini shield. I'm just gonna put them right in front of their faces and attack them with it as well. Ooh, and the explosive criticals actually work on them as well. So let's pull back as far as we can, because we need to start making a defensive perimeter with everybody we still have left. It's sad that I shouldn't have fired with Jazz, because he's gonna be in a bit of a pickle there. I'm gonna try and leave a few of the guys behind as backup.
I'm going.
What is that? What is this?
Commander, not all of our people are back on board.
Ah.
If we lift off now, ooh, we'll be leaving our troops behind.
That is an interesting button. Why is that even there? So I could have... can I actually combat protocol something? Oh yeah, the mech. Duh. With ammo over here. So yeah, the turrets. The turrets on Overwatch, obviously. Yang on Overwatch, Vinny on Overwatch. Does she have... That's capacitor discharge. All units in a radius. Can I actually move that? Oh. Robotic units take more damage. Yeah.
Give him a shock.
Go for it. I mean, why not? Blast away. An extra damage on the mech. Does that get added later on? The officer is disoriented, which is really good as well. Then we have Benito. Let's pull him back over here. And put Geralt over there. Ulrich, pull him back a bit.
Gate clear.
And then put everybody I can on Overwatch. And there's another batch. So yeah, we really, really need to leave. Because they're gonna do that every turn. There's only 2 enemies on each batch. But we really need to leave this place. We don't get the corpses of everything we killed, so it's not even a use for that. So they're just gonna hide, apparently. They're gonna fire at the mech. And not even hitting him. I'm hoping they destroy it and keep it busy. That the mech keeps them busy for a bit. Because he's getting closer. What is he gonna do? Is he gonna fire at Jazz? No, he doesn't. Okay, so it's my turn again. And of course, on the very same spot, they're gonna spawn more enemies.
Menace 1-5, be advised, we've picked up hostile reinforcements inbound on your position.
So I can't get Jazz back into the ship again, but look how far he can run. That guy has some reach. We're gonna put everybody I can. I'm gonna put them inside of the area already. Especially those that are far away. hole. Damn. Could fire, of course, but I don't want to do that. Wait a second. No, I still have my heavy mech, which is really good. Because I'm just going to try and fire at these guys here. This one is closest. Yeah, murdering each other. Mech on mech combat. So, goodbye to you. Yang on Overwatch. We don't want to leave yet. Then, I'm just going to have to play this safe. So,
moving to position.
Ooh, she's not going to get there. So Cedric can go inside and set himself over here. The turrets can go on Overwatch. I think I'm going to have to dash a few of these guys further. Because Vinny, yeah, he can't do anything over there anymore. So let's just put him... Oh, he doesn't even have cover over there. So I'm just going to put him over here.
Rolling out.
Emma. She's not going to reach that in one turn as well. So let's just put everybody I can a bit further. And even Geralt is in a could be in a better position, but I'm just gonna put him on Overwatch. Everybody I can. Ulrich, get the hell out of there, buddy. Go over here, and that appears to be our last option. So let them come to us. They're probably a few of them are still gonna be. Oh, I think the hacking just stopped. I don't have control of that mech anymore. Oh. This might be an issue. Yeah, heavy mech is no longer hacked, but we don't have the sight of them as well, so they're gonna have to come to us. So he marked Emma. He could just see Emma over there, but I think she has Overwatch on. There's the mech. Our mech. Oh, thank you, Geralt. Goodbye, mech. Well, Geralt's introduction is there again. So 5 soldiers remaining to get back into that area. We can see that on the top right for once instead of a freaking timer. And I think, yeah, we're pretty much home free right now. So let's put everybody who's still outside of the area inside of the area. Ooh, Emma is even pretty far away from it. Still. Come on, give me someone who's outside of the area, thank you. And then Geralt, put him inside as well. And I think that's the last one. Yeah, so we're done, right? Recover soldiers, no soldiers remaining, so if we now go for liftoff adventure, this mission is done. Let's get out of here.
Excellent.
What the hell's going on? Yeah.
Looks like the Avenger lives to fight another day.
Emma Hill is no longer marked, yes indeed. So 7 turns taken, we killed 15 of the 21 enemies, and we got a flawless rating anyhow, so and there we go.
We're evening up the score, Commander. Good work out there.
And we even got 2 promotions out of that as well, because Yang got a promotion, so that makes her a Major. Salvo or Hail of Bullets. Unleash a Hail of Bullets that is guaranteed to hit your target, but uses a lot of ammunition. Ah, it's a very nice ability. I do know it's a very, very nice ability. But I think I'm going to go for Salvo, because I'm going to give her Rupture as well. And if I can then use another action to do something else, yeah. Salvo is just so powerful, I'm just going to keep it at that. And then we have Vinny's promotion. Ooh, untouchable on a sharpshooter. If you score a kill during your turn, the next attack during your... against you during the enemy turn will miss. And of course, we're going to go for Fan Fire, which is probably the strongest... Well, the strongest ability you can get on a sharpshooter that's... focused on gunslinging and has EMP rounds, because you can one hit a sectopult with this ability. Fanfire, fire the pistol 3 times at the same target. So yeah, thank you very much for that. Continuing on, I think, does Geralt get a promotion as well? So advanced expanded magazine, advanced stock, superior agility, and advanced agility. And a codex brain. Doesn't seem... I think we have. Let's go to the armory, because I think somebody else got a promotion as well. Do we? Yeah, Geralt got a promotion as well, so that's really, really nice. Because I think I'm going to start using him a bit more as well, so let's promote him. Covering fire, Overwatch shots can now be triggered by an enemy action, not just movement, which is really good. And of course, we're going to go for heavy ordnance, giving him an extra grenade. There we go. So UFO taken care of, which means we can easily continue building that radio relay over here. There we go, because we evaded the UFO to New Australia, but yeah. Training completed, so Allison Church is now our new ranger, so I'm going to continue on. And we got another warsuit, which is really good as well. I'm just quickly going to go to the Guerrilla Tactics School and put in another of the rookies to become... I'm just going to make another grenadier. So Zoltan is actually perfect to be a grenadier in my eyes. Explosives expert, why not, eh? Let's get back to the bridge. And finish up the building. Oh, and we get a new guerrilla operation before that. So let's review the targets. That is interesting. Codex, elite trooper, elite shield bearer, elite officer, a sector pod, a lancer, and a heavy mech. So quite a bit of mechanical units. So EMP rounds are advised. But yeah, we still need to choose, of course. So we get a sharpshooter or supplies or an engineer. We don't need the engineer. New construction reduces the alien facility counter. That's not so big of a problem. Increases detection radii of all enemies and the hidden event. Another sharpshooter is always nice, of course, but I think I'm just gonna go with the supplies. Because there's only 9 enemies here as well. We need to protect the device though. I like destroying it a lot more. But we do need to get a mission with a codex, of course. You know what? I'm just gonna go for West Africa. Seems like the most sensible, because the two other ones aren't that big of a dark event. And we don't know what the hidden event is, so we're gonna go for West Africa. So with everything we know, I think it's not that bad of an idea to go with this squad, although I might remove a few. I don't think I need Cedric, so I'm gonna get him out of there and just swap him out for... I'm actually gonna remove Ulrich for once as well. I'm gonna put Geralt in there. And let's make utility items available, and let's make armor available as well. So let's put... So they're all colonels by now. We might actually go for the Psy operative then, to get a bit of a varied group here. So Yessie is gonna have her first mission then. Just gonna quickly set up everything, and I'm gonna get back to you in a second. So there we go, this is gonna be the team we're gonna head out with. So Emma with a hazmat suit and a skulljack, Jazz with the mimic beacon and the talon rounds, Geralt with the shredstorm cannon on his warsuit, the proximity mines and incendiary grenades, then Yang with also a warsuit with a blaster launcher, plated armor and acid bombs, then Vinny with blue screen rounds as always and the hellweave armor, and then Yessie, our Psy operative, with also a warsuit to protect her a bit more, and with the plasma blaster and the tracer rounds to boost her aim a bit. She also got a stock, an advanced stock, so she should do guaranteed 2 damage on every shot she does. But before we head into Operation Crypt Queen, we're gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye! Yeah,